Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Mayowaoye. Today's tutorial is on how to make a trendy flared hip dress, or more like a trendy flared hip, trendy six pieces flared hip dress, because it's like it has a six pieces panel. So yeah guys, I don't normally do this, but this tutorial is actually based off a request I got on my Instagram on how to make this particular dress. So here goes the tutorial. Don't forget to tap the subscribe button below your screen and tap the like button also. So guys, first things first, you're going to need your basic dress block, and this is mine right here. And if you have always followed my tutorial, you would know that I don't teach how to draft basic patterns. I teach that in my private lessons, my private classes, so I don't do that on YouTube. So yeah, this is my basic dress block. This is my front, this is the front, and then you also need to get one also for the back. I'll show you the back. So yeah, this is my back pattern also. So yeah, now let's proceed. Now guys, the next thing you need to do is to measure the length of your dress. That is how long you want the dress to be. So because if you look at the picture, you'd see that it's a short dress. So for me, I'm like about 6 feet 2 inches. My full length is about 62 inches, but for the dress I'll be using about maybe 37 inches. So just measure from your shoulders to wherever you want it to be, that is above your knee. So I'll be using 37 inches for my own full length. So I just wanted to zoom it a bit just so that it's closer to you. So yeah, this is the length, this is my own hem, the dress length. So now we can proceed with the rest of the tutorial. The next thing will now be to measuring, to drafting the neckline. So the neckline is a simple straight across neckline. So right from my armhole level here, I'm just going to measure about maybe 4 or 5 inches up from here up. So, and that will be where my armhole. So I'll measure the 4 to 5 inches. I'll measure it from here. So this is the mark right here. So I'm going to connect this using my French cover. I'll connect it all the way back to my armhole level right here. So I'll connect this. So this is the neckline drawn out. So at this point right here, this is my dart line. At this point right here, I'm going to measure 1 inch out, 1 inch out here. So once I measure it, and then I'll reconnect it back to my bust point. So let me just do that now. So yeah, this is the dart here. So 1 inch out, 1 inch out, and I reconnected back to my bust point. So now to shaping up the bust area again, I'm going to measure from my shoulders here to my underbust. So just measure from your shoulder to your underbust. My own underbust is 14 inches, so I'll measure 14 inches from here down and locate the mark here. So now this is it. This is the mark right here, my underbust mark. So from each dart leg here, I'm going to measure half inch out, half inch out here. So once I measure it, I'll reconnect it back to my bust point here. And reconnect it back to my bust point here. So right, this is it right here. So now I'm going to connect from here back to my waist here, and then I'll connect it to my waist, that is to the dart leg at the waist right here. So just draw a straight line this way. Now let's draw in this is the connection, the dart connection right here. So I already completed that. So now let's draw in the neck overlay. So for the neck overlay, just measure from here down wherever you want the overlay to stop. So basically you can just do about let's see. So for me, I'm just going to measure right here. From here, I'll just measure 6 inches down, and then at this point again, I'll just measure from here. I can just measure maybe 4 or 4.5 inches down from here down, and then you connect. So I'm just going to connect the 2 points this way. Now for this part, I felt like, you know, I measured 6 inches from here down, so I felt like the 6 inches was too long, so I decided to reduce it. So I just measured about 4 inches from here down, and then the same 4 inches that we have here, just measured that down, and then I connected. So this is my overlay right here. So all you just need to do is to place a piece of paper underneath this, and then you trace this out and then keep it aside. So yeah, this is it traced out. So remember to include the dart here, these darts that we have here, remember to include it, because if you don't, by the time you are sewing, this is going to be larger than this, because we know, you know, we are going to like be closing this, that this, that will no longer be there, we'll be sewing it together. So I'm going to, that's how you need to illustrate the dart here, and then you close it on this pattern. So I've closed the dart. All I have to do is to just like blend it, then bring this line in. So pretty much now I'll just cut this out and then keep this overlay aside, then continue with the actual pattern. So yeah, this is the overlay done, so I'm just going to keep it aside. And then yeah, I think that is all for the upper part of the dress. Now let's move to the lower part of the dress. So now at the hemline right here, I'm going to extend it out a bit because I want to make this part a line. So you can just extend by maybe 4 or 5 inches depending on you. So you can increase it, so if you want to just increase it here, and then once you increase it, you reconnect back to your waist. So this is my waistline here. So yeah, about the A-line, this is it. So instead of drawing a straight line, just use the curved part of your French curve to do that too. And this is the curve right here. So that's that. So now the next thing will be to split this pattern. So I'm going to be splitting this pattern into two. So this part here will be known as the side front, and this part will be known as the center front. So this is how we'll be splitting. So you split it from here. This is the dart line. You go all the way by this, that by the time you get here, go this way, come here, then go this way, and then you come right here, and that's pretty much that for the side front. Now for the center front, you come, you split this way, then you come right here, go this way, then here, 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 all the way down, and that's that for the center. So I'm just going to split that open now, and then I'll show you what that looks like. Now before splitting this open, before splitting the front open, let's quickly work on the back pattern. So the back pattern is really easy. Most of the things we did for the front, you have to do also the same thing for the back. Most of it, not everything. So now the only thing you need, the first thing you need to do is to measure the dress length, the same length as the one we measured for the front. I measured 37 inches for the front, so you measure the same inches right here. Then you come to the neckline and measure the neckline for the back. So if you want a straight across neckline for the back, you do the same thing. So let me just draw the straight across neckline for my back. Now for the back depth, that is the depth for the back. So measure from your armhole level. You can just measure maybe 1 inch down from here. This is my armhole level, so just measure maybe 1 inch down. Then this is it. Then you reconnect back to your armhole level here. So just use your French curve to draw a slant line or a curved line to this part here. So this is my neckline done. So at the back width right here, I'm going to, this is my back width level here. It was already on my basic pattern before I started all of this. So right here, just measure 1/2 inch out and 1/2 inch out from the dart line. This is the dart line. 1/2 inch out here, 1/2 inch out here. Then you connect to any point on your dart leg here, and connect any point to on your dart leg here. So guys, this is the dart here, and now that is, I think that is all we have to do to the upper part of the back. So now we can just now move to the lower parts, and then the same thing we did for the front. At the hemline here, just measure maybe 4 inches out like we did for the front. I think we measured 4 inches out for the front, and then you reconnect to your waist. So use your French curve, the curved part of your French curve, to reconnect to your waist exactly the way we did for the front. So let me not talk, let me not prolong the matter. So I'll just do that now and show you what it looks like. So guys, this is it right here, and that completes the back. So when you want to split this open, this is the side back and this is the center back. So you split the side back this way. Okay, you come to the dart line here, you come here, go this way, then this way, and this is my neckline. We don't need anything here anymore. So you come here, here, then you come here, here, here. So that's that. So this is what I mean. I think that was out of focus. So from the dart line here, this is the dart line, side back comes here, then it goes this way. This is the neckline, so we don't need anything here anymore. And then you come this way, this way, and that's that. Now for the center back, you also come from the dart line here, you go this way, then this way, this way, this, okay, yeah, you go this way too, because this is your zip allowance. So you go this way, this way. So I'm going to do that now and show you what that looks like. So guys, this is it cut open. This is my center front. This is my side front. Now we are heading towards the final bit of the tutorial. So the next thing we need to do, I'm going to pick up, I'll start with the center front, then I'll pick up a piece of paper and then I'll place it this way. I'm just going to tape this down. This is the paper. Now this is the paper attached. I've placed it. So at this point here, I'm going to extend it out. So you can extend by maybe 3 or 4 inches. So just extend it out. So this is it here. You can just mark 3, 4, or 5 inches depending on you, and then you reconnect back to your waist. So this is my waist level. So I'll reconnect this to my waist. So guys, this is it. Now I'm going to cut the rest bit of this paper that I don't need. I'm going to cut it out. So this is it. I've cut the paper, the excess paper out. Now I want to make sure, I want to enlarge this more. So on this line here, you know, it's from here we extended this part here. So on this line here, I'm going to slash it open again. I'll not cut it all the way through. I'll just cut it and stop somewhere here. And then when I cut it, I'll place another piece of paper underneath it and spread this out. Sure, I'll show you what I mean after I'm done. So, yeah. So this is the paper attached. Now I'm going to spread this out a bit like I was explaining earlier. So I'll just spread it out just to give it some more flair around you. So I'll tape this down and cut this out now. So you can spread it out by any amount you want. So I'll probably do about maybe 4 inches for me. So you can, I'll probably do about 4 inches for me to give it some more flair. Right, so this is it. This is it spread out. You can see it's now more enlarged. So yeah, that's that for the center front. Yeah, this is complete. So yeah, we've done this. This is already enlarged. Now I'm going to do the same thing I did here. I'm going to do it here. So yeah, I've extended the line here. Now all I have to do is to just cut this open. So I'll cut this open and stop somewhere around here and then spread it out. So I'll do the same also here. I'll probably spread. So I'll do the same here and just spread this one to just a bit. So I'll cut this, stop here, spread out. Cut this, stop here, spread out. You got the drift. So this completes this part for the side front. So I already spread this out and then also spread this out. So this is my center front, and yeah, that completes it. So you do the same thing we've done for this front, you do the same thing for the back, and once you are done, that completes your pattern. So when you're cutting your pattern side front, you cut 2 pieces for the side front, you cut 1 piece for the center front on fold. So when you're cutting the center back, because I don't have that here, I'm just going to tell you what to do. So for the center back, when you're cutting the center back, you cut 2 pieces because you know there's going to be a zipper in the middle. So you cut 2 pieces for the center back, and for the side back you cut 2 pieces. So I hope you got the drift. Now I'm going to cut this on my fabric now, and then I'll show you what that looks like. So this is the overlay for the neckline. So you cut the overlay on fold, 1 piece. You cut 1 piece on fold. Yeah, that's pretty much everything. So guys, I'm going to have to speed this up, but I just needed to show you this. This is the fabric cutout. This is my center front. So this is the center front cutout. This is my side front, my 2 side fronts. So all I need to do is to just place this way and sew right sides together this way. By the time I sew, I turn it this way, and then I do the same also here. Sew this and then turn here, and then the overlay, this is the overlay. Once I'm done sewing this, I place my overlay, and then this is my overlay. So I place my overlay to this point. So you place right sides together and you sew. So you can place it at the wrong side here, so you can sew at the wrong side here. So you sew the overlay at the wrong side here at the neckline. So by the time you are done sewing, you turn it over this way, and then it falls this way. So I hope you got the drift of the whole tutorial. So I'm really not going to show you how to sew this because the video is already getting too long, and I need to just wrap it up right now. So I'll just sew this now, and the next thing you'll be seeing is the finished dress, this finished dress. So yeah, so guys, this completes our dress, our 6-piece dress, flared dress. So this is the neck overlay right here, and this is the really flared parts. So the really flared parts right here. So basically, so now I'm just going to stand this now, just so that I can see. I'll put this on a stand just so that I can see what the full fit of the dress looks like. Don't forget to tap the subscribe button below your screen, tap the like button also, and turn on the notifications bell so you don't miss any of my upcoming tutorials when I post them. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.